What's up, guys? Thanks for tuning in to West Virginia Astronomy. My name's Jonathan, and I do videos about astronomy and astrophotography from my backyard here in Sinks Grove, West Virginia. It's been a while since my last video, but honestly, it's been a really slow year with a lot of bad weather. The next 4 days, it's supposed to be clear, so I'm going to take full advantage and really get the most out of these 4 nights. I'm on my second night of imaging, and the target that I'm shooting is the Tadpole and Flaming Star Nebula, IC410, I think, located in the constellation Auriga. It is a super cool target. I'm working on a 4-panel mosaic. It's a really wide field shot. There's a lot going on. There's about 3 or 4 different targets located in my field of view. So using my Red Cat 51 at the 250 millimeter focal length, it should give me a pretty wide field. This winter, it's all about wide field deep space astrophotography. I really haven't had a lot of chances to shoot a lot of these winter targets wide field. So yeah, that's pretty much my plan for the winter. It's just to keep this thing running and just seeing what all I can capture with it. So stick around, guys. Join me in the backyard for a full night of astrophotography. Guys, it's around 11 o'clock and I had to work today, so I didn't really get to get out here till now, but I went ahead and started taking my flat frames and just get those knocked out of the way. I just have to do them once and I figured I'd go ahead and knock them out. Last night I was able to gather 30 frames in panel 1 and 35 frames in panel 2. Tonight, hopefully I'll get about the same on panel 3 and then panel 4. If all goes to plan, maybe tomorrow night, if it's still clear, I can get another couple hours on each panel. We'll have about 50 frames in each panel. The reason mosaics are really cool is because you can actually shoot at a longer focal length. They're basically just like doing a panorama, just taking 4 pictures and you're making one picture with a wider field of view. You get higher resolution, you can go bigger on prints, and you can just really see the detail a lot better. I've never really gotten all of these targets in one field of view, so it's pretty exciting. It's always really been one of my favorite winter targets. I'm controlling everything with the ASI Air Pro. There is an actual way you can use telescopius.com to check your field of view and get the exact coordinates for a mosaic, which is pretty easy to do. I've done it a few times on here, which I plan to make a video on that too, but this one I'm just kind of using the little chart here. Let me turn on my screen. The way that I'm doing this mosaic, I just kind of came in here. This right here was my first frame here, and this was my second frame. So I got 30 exposures basically in each one of these. I'm just going to move this down about right there. That will be our panel number 3, and capture this as panel 4. I really like the Flaming Star Nebula. It's just got really strong hydrogen alpha and a strong oxygen 3 signal kind of right in the middle of the bright star AE Auriga. Alright guys, we got a third panel lined up and exposure started. Hopefully this will be enough to really give me a clean image. Nights of gathering data, I have a total of 125 minute exposures in a 4-panel mosaic. Night 3, I plan on just probably gathering 20 more exposures in each one of the 4 panels, and that should give us a pretty healthy signal and help reduce a lot of that noise that tends to show up. I'm just going to keep trucking along, and hopefully this will be one of my favorite images so far. Just keep my fingers crossed that the weather holds and we get a cool image. Thank you. I always try to get someone to come outside with me, but no one ever wants to. But tonight, Stella actually wanted to come out, so I grabbed my binoculars and a laser pointer, and I showed her a few of my favorite constellations. Honestly, I think she was more impressed by the laser pointer. It ended up being 45 300 second exposures in each one of the four panels, and once you have all your data gathered, it's all ready to stack. There's a real easy way you can do this rather than doing four separate stacks and doing it that way. I figured out a quick and easy way to do this. So what I'm using here is Astro Pixel Processor, and I'm going to go ahead and open it up. We're just going to uncheck multi-channel, we're going to uncheck multi-session, and we're just going to load all of these in as a single one night session. So all of the light frames, all of the flats, darks, and dark flats, they all go in as a one night session. So once you have all of these loaded in, let's do flaming star. These tabs up here, you can just go on and skip all the way up to to integrate here. And so I actually ended up stacking 175 300 second exposures. We don't change anything here. I don't really mess with any of the tabs or anything. We're just gonna hit integrate. We named it here and we click OK, and it will create a finished mosaic and spit out the completely stacked, stitched together everything. It's really easy, super cool feature on Astro Pixel Processor. This will take a good while, a couple hours.
2 hours later.
Okay, so once that finishes, you can then come into Photoshop. This is my first successful mosaic, so excuse the edges here. This is what happens when you just try to eyeball a mosaic and you stack it. You end up with these missing edges and stuff like this. But for future mosaics, I will be using the ASI Air and telescopius.com to kind of get my exact coordinates that I need. Mosaics can be pretty intimidating to think about how you got to stack all that data, so this makes that process really easy. So this is what we ended up with. I have processed it a little bit, but this is, I kept the edges on so you could see exactly the field of view that I ended up with here. So that was the first iteration that I did. I came back and I reprocessed and I ended up with this version here. My final image that I ended up with. I'm not really 100% happy with the framing, honestly, but for a first run, I'm pretty happy with it. So you can see there's some good color and this oxygen here. I did take the Flaming Star Nebula that I had did as a panel, and I processed that separately, and I ended up with this. And this is pretty heavily cropped. There's that with the stars, and then I did it without the stars. So really good signal here. I really like the Flaming Star. You can see all the hydrogen gas, and yeah, it just looks really good. Anyway, guys, simple as that, man. Thanks, Abraham Jones, for letting me know about this feature. Hopefully you guys enjoy these images. I will leave a link in the description for the raw data. If you guys want to download those and process them yourself, feel free to do so. That's about it for this one, guys. Hope you got something out of this video, and I can see a lot of mosaic projects for my future. So thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next one, guys. Peace.